Tasha?
Yes?
Oh, I just want to know if you want to go out and grab something to eat. I'll just try back again later. I'm sure she'll think about it.
Take your baby by the hand and make her do a handstand. And take your baby by the heel and do the next thing that you feel. We were so in phase in a dance hall days. We were cool on craze. When I, you, and everyone we knew could believe, do, and share in what was true. Oh, I said, dance all day's long. Take your baby by the hair and pull her close and there, there, there. Take your baby by the ears and play upon her darkest fears. We were so in phase in a dance hall days. We were cool and crazy. When I, you, and everyone we knew could believe, do, sharing what was true. I said, dance all days, love. Dance all days. Dance all days, love. Take your baby by the wrist.
Tupac in your ear for you to listen to when you drop in on the Driskol Estate Show. Man, I love that track. I'm actually going to get into why I love that track so much later on in this episode. I'm just going to leave it alone for right now. I'll bounce back and forth. I was trying to think, you know, what did I want to do with this show? I guess I could tell you guys how not to ask girls out on a date. I mean, that seems to work. Yeah, I'm trying to remember at that point in time in my life, when did I actually notice, you know how girls give you the excuse as to, you know, maybe why they're not going to give you a chance, you know, and try to be nice about it. So I guess you got have to kind of play the friend zone role. Yeah. Normally when they start mentioning their boyfriends more frequently, you know, and sometimes when they mention the boyfriend, they forget that they used a different name the last time they told you. So, I mean, to me, I leave it alone because I figure, well, maybe she just gets around a lot. It actually turns me on kind of more. Kind of good to have a friend like that. Maybe she could teach me something different, teach me something that I'm doing wrong. Yeah. But, what I wanted to do with this, I mean, first of all, let me say that I finally get a chance to deliver material, enough material over a few decades, you know, that I can actually bring to the show and put it together. We're going to be covering Gamer, we're going to be covering movies, music, and if anybody who, you know, tunes in, you know, and wants, you know, to put their input, I have no problem with that. I mean, odds are, you know, I may play a little snippet of something that you say you've been looking for so long and could never find it. Odds are I may have it in the collection. I don't know. But I'm very random. Very, very. I think my favorite of all soundtracks would have to be Grand Theft Auto soundtracks, man. They do such a spectacular job with putting artists on one album to collaborate, or whether they just put their own solo projects. I mean, sometimes they may put an artist on that doesn't even have that release as far as retail. You have to get it on the Grand Theft Auto game. But I just found out that on Grand Theft Auto 5, like right towards the end of the game, they had some Tyler the Creator on there. And I mean, geez, shit, I'm at the last mission, just finishing it up. I turn on the radio, play around with the channel just a bit while, you know, I'm also hanging out the window trying to get a good shot. And Tyler the Creator comes on. I'm like, man, I wish that I would have known this throughout the game. You know, it gives me a reason to go back and play it some more. But, yeah, that's it. That's what it is.
Y'all ready for this?
You know, I have to give it up for The American Hustle. That was a pretty good movie. I went to a matinee to check that out. I mean, I like the full theater experience to myself. Kind of like it's my own personal theater.
Can't leave Danny, I lose custody.
No, you have to take me away. We have to leave.
No, what are you saying?
What are you saying?
Please!
Okay.
Oh
my
God. Will you pull it together?
I'll say I don't love you. That's bullshit.
This is bullshit. We are bullshit. You were bullshit. You were bullshit.
Please don't do this.
I just never thought that you were cutting me.
I could never cut you. I love you. Please don't say this.
Hey. No, I'm done.
I'll say that.
I'm gonna do these four busts, these four cons, to get us out of this. Not just me, but us. And I'm gonna get really close with Richie, the cop, in case we need to use him, if we need another move.
We don't need another move. We need four busts. Am I done?
We are gonna need another move, trust me. And you're gonna be thanking me. The key to people is what they believe or what they want to believe. So I want to believe that we were real.
We are real.
And I want to believe that a man could want me. And I'm gonna take all of that heartbreak and all of that sorrow, and I am going to use it. And I'm going to make Richie think that I want him and that I like him. And I want to be very, very convincing. I'm pissed at you. Because I'm pissed at you. Maybe I do like him. Maybe I like him a lot. From the feet up, right? Baby. Quit your belly aching and come up with something to get us out of this. You're right, I'm in no state to deal with this. So what's it gonna be, Mr. Mastermind?
You know, sometimes I imagine what if an exotic girl just dropped in, just because she wanted to bang the only guy that was in the movie theater. See, I think about stuff like that. Maybe I'll be that guy. But, you know, to no avail. It doesn't happen. So, you know, I just pay attention to the movie and stick to why I really came. But, yeah, it was really good. I mean, you can't go wrong when you add gorgeous actresses like Jennifer Lawrence and Amy Adams and put them in the same scene together. I guess it gives you something to look forward to when you hear about it. Then when you actually see it, you say, okay, this is why I'm here. I mean, the scene that they had together where they were talking to each other in the restroom, just them, the back and forth. I mean, I have to be honest. I mean, it was really on point. They really took care of business with that script.
Doing? You're gonna come in here and judge me for flirting with somebody after you've been fucking my husband for how many years?
You don't have any fucking clue what's going on.
I got a ring on my finger. We have a child together.
He doesn't love you, Rosalind. He loves me, and you know it, and I know it, and he knows it. And it might be done now, but it was beautiful, and it was real. And
stop.
We loved each other.
Shut up.
You scare him, and you manipulate him, and you use your son.
Well, he must like it on some level. He must want it. Because he keeps coming back for it. It's like that perfume that you love that you can't stop smelling even when there's something sour in it. You can't get enough of it. But guess what? He's never gonna leave me. He's always going to want me. And I will make you so sorry, Edith. I will make you so sorry for what you've done to my family. Mark my words.
That is fucked up. I would never say anything that fucked up to anybody, but you do because you're gross inside. You're so fucked up.
Oh, I'm gross inside? Maybe you're gross inside with robbing people and all that shit that you do. Maybe we're both gross inside. That's what Irving loves about us. At least he's consistent. You know, sometimes in life, all you have are fucked up, poisonous choices.
Geekiest geek of all time. Keep moving. We've never
Psycho Beach Party.
What made you
want
to come
I believe
here?
That was in reason. The year.
Wait a minute, guys. I feel my nose blistering. I gotta put some. If you put any of that disgusting white gook on your nose, I will wring your scrawny neck until your eyes pop out.
I'm sorry. I happen to be allergic to the sun.
It's true. Her face turns fire engine red and her lips blow up.
And I get this terrible chafing between my legs.
Spare me the details, Berdine.
Oh, darn, I left my goggles and flippers in the car.
I think you're forgetting the reason we're here. This is a manhunt. Let's set our traps.
Yeah, I don't really think most of you were even thought of. I think you were still kind of like swimming around in your pop's nuts at that time. But, I mean, you could backtrack, check it out. I mean, Amy Adams, she was really, really cute in that movie. She played that role to the T. You know what? To me, she still looks the same. Like, she still looks like the same physique, same adorable, clueless looks. I mean, not clueless, like she don't know what the hell. Well, I don't know what the hell is on her mind, really. Not like I know on a personal level. But yeah, I mean, it was actually a pretty decent movie, really. Kind of like one of those it was before Scary Movie came out. It was like the white version of Scary Movie before it was a scary movie. Now, I love the show entirely and what I'm trying to do here, but I have to say this is my favorite part of the show, and this is where I'm bringing back Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, people. Yes. Yes. Now, I had to let this game kind of grow on me. At first I played it and I thought, okay, you know, it's kind of being a little bit cliche, running amok amongst the streets, gangster talk, gangster rapping, gangs. And then, you know, when you really get into it, like, you can recruit people on your team if you have a job to go do. But this mission in particular is one I really appreciated when you got a chance to fly back to Liberty City. Now, for this part, I picked the perfect song to fly back to San Andreas with, Stone Temple Pilots, Crush. And that really put me in the mood to take it back. I mean, he pulls up at the St. Mark's Bistro, and okay, I knew right then he's going in there to handle business. What other reason is CJ going back to the East Coast for?
Private function, invitation only. Oh yeah? Mr. Leone says otherwise.
He's going in there to take care of business,
shut up.
Pop out like it never happened. Like, yeah, I really appreciated this game throughout its entirety. Even through the end with the battle with Smoke, Officer Tenpenny. I mean, you never knew who you were going to deal with next, but I really jumped into it. When I actually beat the game, I jumped into it just like a couple days, just straight. Like, I was already at the end, and I had left it alone for a while. And then when I jumped back in and started playing it, oh man, it just brought back so many memories. But I have to say that this was my favorite mission when he went to St. Mark's Bistro. It even made me want to pull out Grand Theft Auto 3. Just, you know, or the Liberty City Stories. You know, just to roam around the city a little bit and just get a feel of Liberty City.
You want this, huh?
Wash my sports car. And that means your own personal jet.
If the police can't stop you,
I can't wait till they start doing more spinoffs for the GTA 5, like they did with Part 4. I mean, I'm hoping that's what they do.
Here's some Bowie coming up next, proving you can still wear makeup and make it in life.
Oh man, I tell you, man, that is my favorite Tupac song. I just don't give a fuck. Tupac just pretty much just bought the raw material just straight to your ear. Like, you're gonna listen to whatever the hell I gotta say. And that was just his attitude. I mean, amongst any MC rapper that came out, I have to say Tupac is amongst the top most loyal to the hip hop game that you could just ever mention. I still have a feeling that to this day, if he was still alive, a lot of rappers wouldn't even come out of the booth to this day. Like, they'd probably be making secret tapes that would never be released if Tupac was still here today. Now, with this track, it really gave you the definition of why rap was even started. It was to give us a voice. It was, you know, black people, African Americans weren't being heard. Like, our issues weren't that important to a community to even be spoken about. And if it ever were, only thing that was ever said was that black people were killing each other. And it was a lot more than that. I mean, it just showed how we weren't given respect. And if we stepped in and demanded respect, we were looked at as the threat. But the one interview Tupac did, I forgot who it was with, but it was, I believe it was on Resurrection, a documentary that he had. And he was saying that, okay, first we're asking, you know, okay, can we, you know, come in and eat with this country that we live in? Can we, you know, earn money in this country that we live in? And then we're being told, well, you know, maybe another day, or let me get back with you. Pretty much they're giving you the runaround. So the next time you come back again and say, okay, I'm going to ask again. These times now we're asking. Now, you've been given a runaround so many times, and then when you come back, picking the locks, kicking in the door, and forcing our way in to eat, then all of a sudden, black people are labeled a criminal. Well, we have been asking for so long, allow us to eat. So he was really important to rap as artists. And I wish there were more artists like him today. And that's just stuff that you don't see anymore. But yeah, I have to say, I love this. This is my favorite track, though, in the whole game. I just don't give a fuck. Yeah, and this level, this is the Splinter Cell Blacklist, and this is also a really, really good game that everyone should check out. This is the Pakistani Embassy level that I played. It's kind of like a free play, that's a better way to explain it. And with this, I was kind of pretty much just playing around with them, you know, trying out how my gadgets really operate. The wall mines, those are my favorite, because you just toss them on the wall, guy runs past it, and it just explodes, and it sends an alert, and other guys come around. They wonder, okay, what the hell just happened? Tear gas, toss that into a crowd of wandering opponents, and it's a game that you could just set up booby traps all over the place. One thing that I love to do with Splinter Cell is before I, you know, walk down a hallway or a path, I like to put a wall mine or something behind me just in case somebody wants to come around and I don't want them to get the drop on me and me not notice that they're there. So if I hear that thing go off, then I know that it's somebody walking a routine around me, whether it's the a soldier or a dog. Yeah, they even have dogs on this one that they're more vigilant than there has ever been in any other Splinter Cell.
Don't do anything stupid.
They start this thing now where you get more points, you know, when you hide bodies.
The surviving hostiles are pulling back. You've got some breathing room. Don't relax. The hostiles are getting ready for another charge.
Oh my God, man. You talking about, okay, for men, there's this thing that they may call a mistake. And I guess it's when you get the fling knocked up. By fling, I mean the girl you sleep with, you get her knocked up. And some girls are considered, oh, you know, hey, I wouldn't mind knocking her up. And some girls are considered, oh, you know, she's a mistake. Now, what I'm hearing now is that the guy, Paul George, has gotten a stripper, I believe, in Miami, knocked up. And I'm just now seeing pictures of her. And I have to tell you, my man, if and only if it's considered a mistake, I'd like to make a mistake like that. I mean, she is hot, really. I mean, it's a long list of words in the dictionary you can pull out to give to this girl. I highly doubt that these pics are Photoshopped. I think I have a few, maybe. Hopefully, nobody just uploaded photos and just put her name on these photos. But I gotta say, let me see if I got a few here that I can flash. Okay. All right, if this is her, then, man, I tell you that, I mean, I would not consider that a mistake. That's something that you can actually, like, hold on to. Really. You could. I mean, I don't know if she's crazy flying off the handle. Does she take pictures of your license plate and text them to you and say, I knew you were there? I've had that done before. I mean, do I really consider that flattering? I don't know, it made me look both ways out the door whenever I walked outside. So I don't know, I guess it's just depending on who it is. Yeah, and I'm also wondering if Paul George, well, okay, for people who may not know who Paul George is, he plays for the Pacers. And what I want to know is, did he knock her up in the strip club, or, well, I mean, or was it not? I mean, that's what I'm wondering. I mean, either way, I mean, it'll be fine to me. Hell, I wouldn't mind knocking up a stripper in a strip club that looked like that. A Miami Senorita? I think her name is what, Daniela? I don't know what her last name is.
That sounds dirty.
But anyway, I mean, that ought to keep you busy for a while. I mean, I know for her, you know, it's like, it's a gold mine for her. It'd be a nice little story to tell to your children or your grandchildren. Yeah, I wonder how would a grandchild tell that story that his grandma was in a strip club and was picked up by their grandfather, who was an NBA star. Hey, now that I actually say the story back, it doesn't sound bad at all. I mean, it would be different if, you know, mommy, you know, my grandma was a stripper and the fry cook at Burger King knocked her up in the restroom. And after about 11 months later, a few court proceedings, a few blood tests, damaged property, then hey, I had a grandfather. But nah, who knows how it'll go. Maybe it'll keep it, maybe it won't. Keep us posted, Paul. We really want to know. We really want to know if you want to make an honest woman out of her. Really, really, really concerned, buddy. And kudos. I'm going to give you a round of applause for that. Just to let you know that we support you here at the Driskol Estate Show. Okay, I'd like to thank you for tuning in to the Driskol Estate Show. We're coming to the end. of this episode. And I just want to say, these are really good times for me. You know, sitting up here talking about the way I think about gaming industry, movies that we have coming out, or movies that I've already viewed. I hope to be back for another episode. Maybe YouTube won't cancel my channel for me boring you to death. Who knows? But I'm going to leave you out on this Gangstarr track, B.Y.S. Also a track that comes from the Grand Theft Auto soundtrack, which is really a great album altogether. And next time, maybe I won't burn a hole in it. Alright? See you next time on the Driskol Estate Show. Make your brain feel crap when my rapture traps you. Take your baby by the hand and make her do a handstand. And take your baby by the heel and do the next thing that you feel. We were so in phase in a dance hall days. We were cool on craze when I, you, and everyone we knew could believe, do, and share in what was true. Oh, I said, dance all days long. Take your baby by the hair, pull her close and there, there, there. And take your baby by the ears and play upon her darkest fears. We were so in phase in a dance hall days. We were cool and crazy when I, you, and everyone we knew could believe, do, and share in what was true.